Hi, I'm Patricia Bleckman with KE2 Therm Solutions. In this video, we'll cover the best practices when deploying a wireless monitoring solution like the KE2 EM35. If you're familiar with wireless at all, you already know that structures between the receiver and the transmitter can drastically impact the distance the signal can travel. For example, if your device has to transmit or receive through a concrete wall full of steel rebar, the signal won't make it very far. On the other hand, if the signal is traveling across an open warehouse, it has the best chance to make it the advertised open field distance. With that in mind, it is important to evaluate the space to determine the ideal location for your sensors. Wireless signal is like an umbrella, and it's going out equally in all directions. Try your best to center the EM35 module equal distance from all your sensors, but again, consider obstructions. For example, a floor-to-ceiling stainless steel walk-in that completely separates the sensor and the edge manager is not the best scenario. The good news is that you can use the KE2 EM35 sensors to help you out. So once you've unboxed the edge manager, go ahead and locate it where you think it should be permanently placed. Connect the antennas and the USB Bluetooth adapter, then power it on. Next, connect to the EM35 and open the browser of your choice. Enter the IP address of the Edge Manager or https://EM35 and you'll reach the webpage of the EM35. Next, power on the sensors. They should automatically publish to the dashboard. Start with one sensor by locating its MAC address on the label. Then find that MAC address on your dashboard and click the link to open that sensor. Once the sensor page is loaded, clicking on the status light will change the view to an actual timer that will be beneficial in determining the sensor's location. Now that you're set for success, place the sensor in the desired location and return to the web view's status and make sure that the sensor is checking in a reasonable time. If the timer is reading 1 second or less, it's ideal. And below 10 seconds is still pretty good. If the time is 20 seconds or more, you should consider moving or changing the orientation of the sensor. Upright, with the sensor's element facing up, provides the strongest signal. Once the location for the first sensor has been validated, mount the sensor with the included double stick tape or the Velcro mounting pad. Repeat for each additional sensor. Once all the sensors are placed and checking in properly, then it's time to connect to the network. If it's feasible, a physical Cat5e or Cat6 Ethernet cable is preferred, but the EM35 is fully capable of tethering to the local wireless network as well. If using tethering and you need wireless access to the EM35 in the future, then select the Tether plus AP option. If you don't want a wireless access point, then select just Tether. This option will require you to physically cable into the EM35's LAN port for future modifications. One other thing to consider, each wireless sensor has a free year of KE2 Smart Access, so don't forget to set up and publish your sensors before you leave. For more information on the Edge Manager and KE2 wireless sensors or KE2 Smart Access, see our other videos, visit our website, or call our technical support line.